But because I have this offset load, my opposite arm is loaded compared to my front leg, you create this need for a lot of cross-body stabilization. So fantastic for building a lot of core strength. What's up? This is Marcus Martinez, Master Kettlebell Coach. Today we're going to talk about one of my favorite exercises, and that's the kettlebell swing. And if you have had any time in the kettlebell world, you have absolutely performed a swing. But why be limited to just one variation of swings or two variations of swings when there are so many ways to swing a bell? So here's a few of my favorites. So the first one we're gonna go over, we're going to change up the stance. So typically when you're doing swings, you're staying in this nice, even bilateral stance, just focusing on that hinge extension. But now we're gonna break that up and go into a staggered position. So with the staggered position, this is gonna allow me to focus primarily on one side. I still have the support of the other leg. I'm still creating the same mechanics as I would if I was performing a two-hand swing. Hinge, extension, standing nice and tall, creating a lot of tension throughout my lumbo-pelvic hip area. So I wanna make sure everything stays nice and tight so I don't make any issues with my lower back. So what I wanna do with this, I'm gonna start with that stagger position. How far you stagger it is up to you. Didn't mean to do that. So I can stagger it really far and get a lot of an unbalanced position, or I can go just slightly staggered. Either way, I'm gonna start with the stagger position from right here. So now I'm able to focus primarily on this front leg. I got the support of my back leg, but because I have this offset load, my opposite arm is loaded compared to my front leg, you create this need for a lot of cross-body stabilization. So fantastic for building a lot of core strength. And again, that unilateral strength of that one side. So that's number one.